that you are already filled with this food that brings us eternal life. So you have already tasted the delight of the kingdom of heaven. But even so, I implore the Holy Spirit to inspire me a few words to share with you. Then, I want to begin this homily with a question. Why does the church spend so much time to meditate on the bread of life? Do you know the answer? Do you know? I will try to give a sequence of answer. First, because this bread of life is what we celebrate every Sunday, the Eucharist. Jesus gives himself to us each time we go forward to receive Holy Communion. During the consecration, under the effect of the Holy Spirit, through the Eucharistic prayer and the hands of the priest, the bread and wine that we have offered become the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Whenever we celebrate this mystery, we remember the mystery of the incarnation of Jesus, our God, who humbles himself to raise up us. Is what Jesus says in the gospel this morning. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, they will have eternal life. The Eucharist, this bread of life, is the source and the top of our Christian life and of all evangelization. To eat the flesh and drink the blood of Jesus is to have life, eternal life. This eternal life consists of an intense, intimate, deep, invisible, and indivisible relationship with Jesus. He says it himself, those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me and I in them. To remain in Jesus is to put ourselves in his steps. It is to accept that he conducts our life, to trust him at all times and in all circumstances. To remain in Jesus is to enter into relationship with him, to make one with him. To abide in Jesus does not mean to flee the world and the reality in which we live. On the contrary, it means to carry Jesus everywhere we go. At the restaurant, at the market, at home, at work, in the street, everywhere we go, we carry Jesus. To remain in Jesus is not to let ourselves by many traditions of the world. Hatred, jealousy, selfishness. To remain in Jesus is to become what we receive. And if that means to become an alter Christus. To become the place where Jesus lives. Our hearts becomes a tabernacle every time we receive the body and blood of Christ. Then ourselves to become the bread of life for others. To give ourselves to others and to bear Jesus to our surroundings. To be the reflection and the representation of Jesus for our brothers and sisters. To do for them what Jesus would have done for them. By filling ourselves up with his flesh and blood, we must be like Jesus. If this spiritual nourishment does not produce this effect in us, vain is our Sunday communion. This food must transform us. Become what you receive, and you will have eternal life. By eating of the body and the blood of Jesus, he invites us to something bigger and extraordinary. He invites us to go to heaven with him. Your ancestors ate the manna and they did and they died. But whoever eats this bread will live forever. Jesus tells us. This week, brothers and sisters, we celebrated the Assumption of Mary, the first one to carry Jesus to us. I have the intuition that Jesus wants to test us this morning. The one who does not eat the spiritual food does not live and cannot hope to have life without end. This bread of life nourishes and develops our hope, supports our faith, and invites us to a new path. The path of love that drives us to God, our love, and our neighbors. Happy, happy, happy we are to be invited to share the body and the blood of Jesus. Brothers and sisters, let us ask Jesus, our bread of life, to remain united with him everywhere and always, and help us to bring this bread to all those who are hungry and thirsty for his presence in their lives. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.